गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन, दिस इज जयश्री, पीजीटी बॉटनी, टीएसएमएस, मुट्रासपल्ली, गजवेल. वेलकम टू डिजिटल क्लास. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सक्रीशन, द वेस्ट डिस्पोजिंग सिस्टम. अर्लियर सेशंस ऑफ दिस लेसन यू केम टू नो हाउ एनिमल्स आर लिबरेटिंग देयर वेस्ट मटीरियल्स आउट ऑफ द बॉडी. टुडे वी विल सी एक्सक्रीशन इन प्लांट्स, हाउ दे विल लिबरेट द वेस्ट मटीरियल्स. Today we will discuss how plants excrete their materials. Excretion and release of substances in plants. A variety of end products are produced during metabolism, and these are nitrogen waste important. All animals have special type of excretory organs to eliminate the waste materials. Do flowering plants have such excretory organs? We will discuss now. Excretion in plants. Plants do not have special excretory system to remove waste. There are several methods in plants to eliminate the waste. During photosynthesis and respiration, carbon dioxide, oxygen and water produced as additional materials. This oxygen, when it is in excess, it exits outside the cell through stomata of leaves and lenticels of stem. Here, diffusion process involves. Gaseous exchange takes place
their concentration to lower concentration.
What are lenticels? Means lens shaped cells that are present on woody bark, and get rid of excess water by the process like transpiration and guttation. Guttation means the loss of excess water as liquid drops from the margins of leaves of herbaceous plants. This occurs when root pressure is high and transpiration is low. The water usually contains sugars and salts. In plants, waste materials may be stored in leaves, bark and fruits. When these dead leaves, barks and ripened fruits fall off from the tree, waste materials are get rid of. Waste are stored in the fruits in the form of solid bodies called raffia. Chlorophyll breaks down other products in leaves, give the characteristic autumn color seen just before leaf fall off. Plants, several products were produced which helps in their defense. These are stored in various parts of the plant like in roots, leaves, seeds, etc. for the product that eats them. Some of the plants secrete chemicals when injured. These chemicals seal the wound and help the plant to recover from an injury. Some other plants release attractants for other animals, which helps the plants for pollination, seed dispersal, or even for their nutrition. Example, root nodules secrete chemicals to attract rhizobium bacteria into the surroundings to form a symbiotic relationship. These are called secondary metabolites. The biochemical substances produced in plants are of two types: primary metabolites, secondary metabolites. Primary metabolites are usually required for normal growth and development, whereas secondary metabolites are not required for normal growth and development. Example, alkaloids, tannins, resins, gums and latex are secondary metabolites. These are produced for plants' own use, but man is using these products for commercial benefits. We will discuss these secondary metabolites one by one. First, alkaloids. These are nitrogenous byproducts and poisonous. These are stored in different parts of the plant. We will see some common alkaloids in plants and their uses. Phenine, Cinchona officinalis, Cinchona plant. It stores phenine in bark. It is used as a anti-malarial drug. Nicotiana tobacum. It is stored in leaves. It used as the insecticide and stimulants. Morphine and cocaine. Papaverum somniferum. Opium plant. It stores it in fruit. It is used as a painkiller. Rowlapia serpentina plant produces reserpine. It stored in roots. It is used for medicine as a snake bite and high BP. Caffeine, nimbin or other common alkaloids, they are used as CNS stimulant and antiseptic drugs. Next, Next, another type of secondary metabolites are tannins. Tannins are a type of bitter waste material used for tanning of leather for preparing ink. Next, latex. It is a sticky, milky, white emulsion of proteins, gums, resins, etc. Next, resins occur mostly in gymnosperms, in specialized resin ducts. These are used in varnishes preparation. Gums. Neem, acacia plants oozes out a sticky substance called gums. When branches are cut, it helps in healing of damaged parts. It also used as adhesives and binding agents in medicine preparation and in food industry. These are common secondary metabolites. Next, Brugman, a botanist, proved that roots not only absorb fluids from soil but return certain secretions into soil. Example, single apple crop for 4 to 5 years in the same field failed to produce fruits even after usage of a lot of fertilizers. It means that roots are secreting some chemicals into the soil which will affect the yielding of the crop. Last but not least, we will discuss about excretion versus secretion. Excretion is removal of waste outside the body. It is a passive in nature. Example, tears, urine and sweat in human beings. In plants, nitrogenous waste materials are produced, whereas secretion is a movement of materials from one point to another point. It is an active in nature. Example, enzymes, hormones and cells moving from one part of the body to another part. Here energy is utilizing, that's why it is an active nature. Next, in plants, latex, resins, gums, these are secreted and are used as secondary metabolites. So this is about the process of excretory system in plants. Hope you have understand the excretion process in plants. Thank you.